Hi, I'm Stacey. You have probably already heard that the GMAT is moving online, and I'm mostly excited because I'm glad that we can get in there to take the exam again, although there are some weirdnesses to this exam that we need to talk about. So you may have already heard people talking about this online whiteboard thing. They're not going to let us do our scratch work just on paper the way we'd normally do, but we have to do it on an online whiteboard. And when I first heard that, I was like, no, I'm terrible with technology. That sounds like a terrible idea. I've looked a little bit more into it, and I'm a little bit less nervous than I was, but I'm still pretty nervous. I'm actually going in to take the exam on April 20th, the first day that it's available. So I will let you know what I think after it's over. But the reason that I'm less nervous is that our tech team, they heard about this and they dove in and they built the tool. They basically recreated the tool so that I can practice. And so that you can practice too. We're actually making this available to everybody for free so that everybody has something to practice with before they get in there for the real test. So I'm really excited about that. And let's take a look at it. So this is what it looks like. And in fact, this is built on the exact same open source software platform that the official one is built on. So the real thing really should look very much like this. So we've got a pen tool. We can do this when we have to do some kind of annoying math. Oh, but I made a mistake and I want to erase it. I can do that too. I've got some tools here to do geometry and of course to type. I probably won't use the polygon tool or the eyedropper tool. The pan tool though, this I'm excited about. It's more exciting than it looks like at first. So pan tool is literally just to pan around. I discovered as I was playing with it, this thing is like infinite. It's basically an endless sheet of paper. So I can just keep panning or keep scrolling and go do whatever I want, which solved a huge problem for me because at first I thought I was going to have to do the work for a problem or two and then clear it all. And then what do I do if I want to write down some equations at the beginning or I want to write down my time management plan at the beginning, but then I can't keep it because I have to keep clearing it to be able to do more work. So this pan thing, coupled with this down here, this zoom in and zoom out, watch what I can do. So I'm gonna zoom all the way out. I'm all zoomed out right now. At the beginning of the section, I'll zoom out. I will draw a grid on my screen that's gonna be where I'm gonna answer all of the questions. And I'll draw it, I need to count it out properly, but I'll draw it so that I've got 31 squares for the quant section of the exam. And at the end of each row or maybe column, I haven't decided if I'm gonna go down or across yet, I will write down how many minutes I should still have left on my clock by the end of that row. So I'm gonna do that all the way down. And then I'm going to start zooming back in again and panning to the beginning, to the first square basically in my, it's a little clunky, but the first square in my grid here. And what this allows me to do is to have a full screen, a full whiteboard to do the work on my first problem, but then not to have to go erase it or to clear it in order to keep working. I'm just going to scroll to the next one and do that one and then scroll to the next box to do that one. And then by the time I get to the end of the row, I'm going to be able to see, am I on time or do I need to speed up or am I going too fast and I need to slow down? So this is awesome. I'm super excited about this. The other thing I'm super excited about, by the way, is I noticed this as I was doing practice problems last night. I no longer have to do the screen and then look at my scrap paper and then screen. And what was that equation? Did I write that equation down right? Yeah, I did. Okay. Oh, no, wait, that's a 3, not a 2. Okay. Right. Like this just constant up and down as you're trying to work on the scratch paper. We get to have the problem next to the scratch paper. They're side by side. I literally don't have to write down as much because the problem and the scratch paper are side by side. So I'm really excited about that. And I'm hoping that that's going to make up for the fact that it's a little bit clunkier to do my work on screen than to do it on a piece of paper. We'll see. I'll let you know after I take the test. Down here, a couple more tools. I can change the color of whatever it is that I'm writing. I can also change the fill. I doubt I'll use that. And I can change the background color. I probably won't use that either. If I make a mistake, like I meant to write X there, but I kind of messed it up a little bit, look, I can undo. So if I make a mistake and notice it quickly, I can just undo a couple of steps and get rid of it. Or if as I'm working, I accidentally like do a stray mark across the screen that I didn't mean to do, again, I can just get rid of it very quickly. So that's cool too. And then when I get to the end of the quant section and I'm gearing up to do verbal, I'm going to clear the entire screen so that I've got a nice clean workspace to get going on verbal. So that's it. So there you go. So there you go. That's what the online whiteboard is like. It is clunky in various ways. There are actually, though, a couple of advantages to it that I was not expecting when I first started using it. So I'm going to keep playing with it. My colleagues are playing with it now as well. And you can too. So start practicing with it. Get in there, just get used to it. We will have more information for you as soon as we get in there and take it, and we'll let you know the best ways to use this thing to maximize your performance on this exam. So go practice. Good luck, happy studying, and talk to you soon.